this is pages 5 and 6 from the A2 Div 2 pack, and it's about convexity and concavity. It's a little bit interesting, really. It's new to the spec compared to the old A-level teaching, and it can be a bit of a head scratcher, but there is an easy way of remembering it towards the end. Right, so let's just look back at the first year stuff. So if it's increasing, we know that the gradient, that dy by dx is greater than zero there. So we know if it's increasing. We know if it's decreasing, we know that dy by dx is less than zero. And if it's stationary, we know that dy by dx is zero. So them are the things that we know. Right, so let's have a look at this list bit here. So it says curve A is increasing on the gradient's increasing. So it's convex. So convex is increasing and increasing. So, but there's another example on curve C for convex. And it's about the gradient increasing, if you look. So the gradient's increasing. Now then, let's have a look at B. B says it's increasing, but the gradient is decreasing, so it's concave. And D says it's decreasing, but the gradient is decreasing, so it's concave. So we're linking it to the gradient. There. Okay. Right. Now then, if you imagine A and C stuck together. So A and C stuck together, but actually doing it is C and A first. You're going to get a curve which goes like that. So sticking A and C together, you'll get a curve like that. So it says a straight line joining A two points lies above the curve between those two points. Convex curves have an increasing gradient. So a curve is convex if the second differential is greater than or equal to zero. Now there is a little bit of dispute there whether it's greater than or equal to, or if it's just greater than. Now if I try and put curves B and D together, I get that shape there. So a concave has got a decreasing gradient. Which means that that would be less than or equal to for all values. And that's how the example kind of wants us to remember our convex and concave, that the second differential is greater than or equal to zero for convex, and the second differential is less than or equal for concave. So there's a little picture here to try and help you. So the convex is like the U-shape, and the concave is like a cave entrance. And you could also think that convex is like an e to the x. Convex, because it's going up. If you think about the gradient's getting more as it goes up. So that's all of page 5 done, after a bit of head scratching about what it means. So let's have a go at an example then. So we've got an example which is y equals x to the half. So I've got y equals root x. If I do a little sketch of root x is like a falling down x squared graph. It's actually, it's inverse, isn't it? If it's a one-to-one relationship. Okay, so let's have a look then. So I know that y is x to the power of half. So if I differentiate it, so dy by dx is a half x to the minus a half. Now it wants me to see if it's convex or concave at 3, 9. So let's have a look what the gradient's doing at 3, 9. So at 3, 9, so dy by dx is evaluated at x is 3, is a half 3 to the minus a half. So that's going to be 1 over 2 root 3, Serding that up will give me root 3 over 6. Now that gradient's positive, isn't it? So that's just our telling me that it's an increasing or decreasing. So it's increasing here. So I know, oops, that it's increasing at 3,9 as dy by dx is greater than 0. So I know it's increasing. So that's part A done. Right, let's have a look at part B then. So I want to know if it's convex or concave. So part B, remember what we said on the previous page? Convex and concave is your second differential. So let's differentiate it again. So if I know that dy by dx is a half x to the minus a half, so if I differentiate it again, so dty by dx squared, it's minus a quarter x to the minus 3 over 2. And I need to sub in my x is 3. So d2y by dx squared evaluated at x is 3 is minus a quarter 3 to the minus 3 over 2. If you stick that straight in your calculator, you get minus root 3 over 36. And if you look, d2y by dx squared is less than 0, therefore my y is root x must be concave at 3,9 there. Because if you look back, concave is less than or equal to 0. So being really technical, I should really have a less than or equal to there, shouldn't I? But that, I don't like the less than or equal to, or the greater than or equal to. Because at zero, what you're saying it is? Is it concave? Is it convex? Who knows? I don't really like that. Right, we're on 7 minutes. I wonder if we can get through this example two. So I've got, so it says determine the set of values for x, which f of x is convex. Do you know what? I might stop it and we'll do example two on a separate.